हेलो, माय नेम इज़ अर्पण पंडित एंड आई एम फ्रॉम आत्मिया कॉलेज। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी जीटीयू पेपर सॉल्यूशन जुलाई 2010। दिस पेपर इज़ ऑफ द इंजीनियरिंग ड्राइंग। वी विल सी द पेपर सॉल्यूशन स्टेप बाय स्टेप। आई विल शो यू हाउ टू डू द पेपर सॉल्यूशन परफेक्टली। लेट्स हैव क्वेश्चन नंबर वन। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन इज़ अबाउट ऑर्थोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शंस। इन दिस we need to draw the projections using the third angle projection method. We need to draw three views. First would be elevation, next would be top view, and third would be left hand side view. We need to give the dimension using unidirectional system. Let's have a look at the figure number one. So this is the figure number one. As you can see, arrow X, this would be your front side. From this direction we need to check out all the views. The X direction shows the front view, another side shows the bottom view. If you look down from the X side, then it would be your rear view. We need to draw first of all elevation looking from the direction X using the third angle method. First of all, we will have a look at how third angle projection method works. Let's see how third angle projection method works. This would be our reference line. Front view will always be in the center. In the third angle projection, top view will be on the top side, bottom view would be on the bottom side, right hand side view would be on the right side, left hand side view would be on the left side, and if you want to have the rear view, then the rear view would be beside to the right hand side view. So this is how third angle projection works. This is how third angle projection works. Now we'll see the difference between this first angle and third angle projection. The front view would be in the center always, as it is our main view. In reference to this, we are plotting all the views. If you see, front view would be always in the center. The difference starts here. Bottom view would be on the top side of the front view. Top view would be on the bottom side of the front view. In respect to front view, left hand side view will be on the right hand side, right side to the front view, and left hand side view would be on the right side of the front view. If you want to plot the rear view, then the rear view will always be beside after right hand side view, so it will be on the left side. This is first angle projection method. Front view in the center, top view in the bottom. Bottom view would be on the top, left hand side view in the right side, right hand side view in the left side. It would be totally opposite to the third angle projection method, but our front view would be always in the center. Now we'll see how we can trace the projections for this figure. We are having a figure over here and we are having x direction. So in respect to this, we are going to plot the views. First of all, you can see two circles, one cylinder of R35 and another cylinder is of R25. If you are looking any cylinder from the front side, it would be look like a rectangle. How we can do this, we'll see. First of all, we are going to draw a reference line. Now we'll start the projections. We are having first of all R35 cylinder, which means that we need to draw a line of 35 mm horizontal whose height is 90 mm. If you see, whose height is 90 mm. The height is 90 mm. Now, if you look at the figure, you will see that there is a center distance given from the R35 and the R15. So we need to plot this center distance. The center distance is given as 60 mm. So from the center of this 35 mm cylinder, we are going to plot 60 mm distance. First of all, we will have a center of this 35. From this center, we are going to plot a 60 mm line for another circle's projection. I'm going a light reference line. Now again, if you look at the figure, you will see that the total curve is given as 60 mm, which means that its radius is 30. So 60 plus 30 would be 90. So from the center distance, the outer portion of this would be 90 mm. So we are adding 30 mm additional. Now, if you look at the figure once again, then you will see that this portion is lifted 10 mm above this cylinder height. This cylinder is lifted 10 mm. So we'll mark a line at 10 mm. And put a horizontal line exactly to the lower line like this. The thickness of is given as 15 mm. thickness of it is given as 15 mm. So I'm going to draw a 15 mm thickness line. I'll make this portion darker. I'll make this portion darker. So if you look at the figure, then you will find out that this cylinder and this cylinder having clearance of 10 mm. That's why it's been lifted up. This total distance is given as 90 mm. This total distance is given as 90 mm. Hence, from the center line, we have plotted the distance of 90 mm. Now, if you look from the top side, you will see that the center distance is given as 60 mm for a circle. So we will put a center line at 60 mm and put a hidden line for the diameter 15 circle. Now again, if you look at the figure, you will see that on this radius 35 cylinder, we are having another cylinder as well. This cylinder is given as R15 and diameter 15, which we cannot see. So we are going to have this kind of portion. We are going to have a portion like this, R15, which means that from this distance we are having the distance of 15 mm, and from there we are having a radius of 15. Its thickness is given as 10 mm, as it is joined with this cylinder at 15 mm. It will be joined like this. It will be joined like this. Now we are having a R35 and we are having a radius of 25 inside, which we cannot see. So we will put a hidden line for the same. We'll put hidden line for the same. So this is how we can draw the elevation. Now if you look at the question, you will see that we need to give dimensions using unidirectional system. Now if we want to give the dimension using unidirectional system, then the dimensioning style would be extended line close field arrow on the both side. close field arrow on the both side, dimension in the middle. R35, same way total distance to be given as 90 mm, close field arrow on the both the sides, dimension in the middle. This distance is given as 15 mm. This distance is given as 15 mm. Hence, 15 mm on this side. Total height of the cylinder is given as 90 mm. Total height of the cylinder is given as 90 mm. So we will give the dimension of the 90 mm over here. We are having this thickness as 15 mm, close field arrow on both the sides, and we will put 15 mm over here. And without fail, we will mention that this is our elevation or front view. This is our elevation or the front view. Now, we will plot the top view from this same. For this, we will put again a reference line, in whose reference we are going to draw the projections for the top view.